Today, I will explain how to use PoweApps Text Input Control and its command use properties. Hi, this is Mike Nigami, Lean Sigma Bugbear. From the operation screen, click Insert and Text. You'll see Label and Text Input Controls, which you'll frequently use. You can simply write text in the label control. But today's theme is the other one, the text input control. It allows the user to enter their information, and the app can use that information to do other processing. In a simple example, prepare two text input and one label control. In the label, let's output the total value of both the values entered in the text input controls. In the label's text property, I put textInput1.text plus textInput2.text. A label name.text means the content of the label. In preview, enter numbers in the text input controls, then you'll get their total in the label. When you change the input, your total is recalculated automatically, like Excel. Select each control and click the down arrow on the formula bar. Then you'll see many properties for each control. At first, you only need to remember what you use frequently. The first ones are the ones we use the most, the onSelect and onChange properties. The action of the formula written there will be triggered when the user taps the control with onSelect and when the state of the control changes with onChange. Since most of the controls have these properties, I'll go through them in depth in other videos. The next one is the visible property. If you put false there, it will be hidden. You can also choose it from the tree on the left, even if it's hidden. You can unhide it by putting true there. Since mobile apps are on a small screen and you want your app to be intuitive, this feature is essential. I've made a detailed video about this separately, so please take a look at it later. If you put text in the default property, the text will appear in the control when you open the screen for the first time. If you put text that the users use most often, it will be helpful. Also, instead of that, you can use the hint text property too. This is initially grayed out, but as soon as the user taps on it, it will be an input state, so you can give instructions indirectly to the user. I also often use the mode property. You can change the display mode by putting a single line or multi-line. If users might enter long sentences, put multi-line, then they will also be able to add a new line in the box. If you put number in the format property, users can only enter numbers so that you can prevent users from making entry mistakes if you want to allow the users to enter only numbers. If you put true in the clear property, X will come out after the user's entry and they can delete the entry easily just by clicking the X. I explained a lot about the text input control today. I put a link to Microsoft's official page about the text input control in this video description, so please refer to it. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.